Well, good morning, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. This is the last day of our study through the book of Philippians. I know when we started, and I think we started on January 1st, I said that it would be the month of January, and here we are, February 2nd. We didn't make it. Came close. You got to give me that. But we're going to finish today. And then I have a special, really interesting next 2 days to finish out the week. Something that you don't know. It's going to be fun. It's going to be a lot of fun. But anyway, for today, we have one little paragraph and ending to go. And so I want to jump in. It's Paul's personal greetings. So he had shown love for the Philippians, hasn't he, all throughout this letter. And I mean, some just awesome things that the way he shows that, because he loved them because they were partners in ministry with him and they supported him. And boy, I hope you saw yesterday's show. You could really see the way that the Philippians showed their love for Paul and for the spread of the gospel. It wasn't just for Paul. And so some great verses. But as a final reminder here, that these were his friends. They're his friends. Let's just read chapter 4, verse 21, and it says, "Greet all the saints in Christ Jesus. The brothers who are with me send greetings. All the saints send you greetings, especially those who belong to Caesar's household. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit. Amen." This whole letter is like a prayer, a thankfulness to God for them. But didn't you, I get a kick out of the fact that he says, greet the saints in Christ Jesus. That's them. So he's calling the Philippian church a church of saints, of the saints. But he also says the same thing, verse 20, all the saints here send you greetings. So they were saints there. There were saints here or in Rome where he was. I love that. And of course, we talked about how we all are saints in the sense that God has forgiven our sins and wiped them out, sent them as far away from us as the east is from the west, forgiven us for those sins. And then when he sees us that way, we are saints. This is a point that's driven home again and again by Paul in this letter. And I think he does it in a way, it's an encouragement to live up to that and to be a part and to live like that as a saint. So I see it as just an encouragement toward godly living. And it really is. But did you catch the end of that? Especially to those saints who belong to Caesar's household. That's a cause for rejoicing, isn't it? When you think about it, how are there saints in Caesar's household that he, Paul, even knows? He knows them, evidently. I think it's a result of Paul's witnessing to the Roman guards that were chained to him. I mean, can you know that Paul is constantly talking with them about the Lord and then challenging them to faith? And clearly some responded. And then when they're not chained to him, they're off in Caesar's household. Now, what do you think they're doing there? I'm sure they're sharing their faith there. At the Royal White House. No, he didn't have a White House. Probably a palace. And so the word of God gets spread from Paul to the guards, to their friends and other people at the top levels. It's just like God, isn't it? To bring good or great out of a miserable situation. And I just get from this, yeah, he's sending greetings, but I just rejoice that he even lets them know there are believers in Caesar's household. A wonderful, wonderful letter. And of course, he gives them the final blessing. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. There's nothing better that you could offer to your friends. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. We all need grace, don't we? It's a great way. It's a great way for Paul to end his letter. I hope this letter has been an encouragement to you, as it has been for me. I so appreciate it. Hey, in our last couple of minutes this Wednesday, there's a couple of things happening this weekend at Saddleback Laguna Woods that I want to mention to you. The first is on Sunday, and we're having a special Sunday this week. I hope you'll come on out and enjoy it. We're calling it, and we just made up this name, but it's the theme for the Sunday, God Loves You Sunday. God loves you. We just want to drive that point home to everyone who attends. There's going to be a special music that carries that theme. There's going to be a special keepsake gift that we're going to give to you that'll bring that theme home with you. And even throughout the morning, you know, February being Valentine month, you're going to see hints of that, because we may not have a boyfriend or a spouse or whatever right now, but God can be our Valentine. He is the one who loves us. There's no question about that. So we're going to have a special Sunday. I think it's going to be a lot of fun, but it's also going to be a pretty, very inspirational. It's something we've never done before. So come on out, Clubhouse 5. 9 or 11, we still will be serving our breakfast with hard-boiled eggs and then other vegetables, as well as coffee, tea, and donuts. So be a great Sunday to give church a try. Come on out. We'd love to meet you. Hey, on Saturday, and we've talked about it one other time during this, is Saturday is our 101 new members class. And just call the number below or let us know that you be coming, because there's quite a bit of free material that we give you that day. We want to make sure we have enough for you. Again, a small breakfast and coffee will be served. So you don't need to eat in advance, and we'll serve you. But it's a wonder. It's our most, by far, our most popular and highest attended class that we ever do. And we do it fairly often, but it is this coming Saturday at 9 o'clock, Clubhouse 5, but in the front room, room 1. So we hope you'll come. We'd love you to sign up in advance, but even if not, just come on out. That'll be fine. We try to bring enough extra, and we will find it for you. But what you'll learn is the history of Saddleback Church, the history of Saddleback Laguna Woods, and what we believe. Why does Saddleback exist? And what are the doctrinal, what are the truths that we hold on to? It's a fast-moving class. I have always asked people, and they totally enjoy it. So 9 o'clock, 9 to approximately 11:30, I think, maybe a little longer. But with breaks and so on, it goes fast. So that's this Saturday, and then Sunday, again, is our God Loves You Sunday. Well, I've really enjoyed walking through the book of Philippians with you. I thank so many of you for the positive feedback. We have studied books before a couple of times in the 4 years, well, over 900 shows now, but this was special. It was special for me, too. Thank you. And hey, we'll see you tomorrow. Like I say, the next 2 days, fun shows. See you tomorrow. Bye.